followed by the methane. Next one is nitrous oxide. Nitrous oxide is nothing but N2O. It is naturally produced in ocean from biological sources of soil and water due to microbial action and rainforest. Yes, nitrous oxide also produced with the help of ozones from biological sources, especially inside the ozone, especially microorganisms like bacteria, with the help of bacteria, nitrous oxide that can be able to evolve. And rainforest, always the forest, the rainfall is throughout that can be able to occur. Due to that, the nitrous oxide that can be able to evolve. Next one is man-made source, that is including the nitrous oxide that can be able to formed with the help of nylon and nitric acid production. Then use of fertilizer in agriculture, manure, car with catalytic converter and burning of organic matter. Yes, due to the man-made activity, usage of nylon, production of nitric acid, usage of synthetic or chemical fertilizer in agriculture, manure, then car with catalytic converter and burning of organic acid that can be able to emit the nitrous oxide. Due to the carbon dioxide emission, methane and nitrous oxide, the global warming that can be able to affect the plants. Global warming effects on plants. First one is low agricultural productivity in tropic. Yes, the global warming, that greenhouse gas that can be able to affect the plant, that carbon dioxide that can be able to affect the plant, the production that can be able to low, the yield that can be able to low in the tropics. Then frequent heat waves, especially weed, pest, fungi need warmer temperature. Yes, the temperature increases, the weed increases, pest increases, and other microorganism that can be able to increases in a particular temperature, fungi also increases, that can able to reduce the plant growth. Then increasing of vector and epidemic. Here increasing of vector is nothing but insects. The insect act as a vector for the plant diseases. That plant disease that can be able to cause the epidemic. Here the insect leg, they contain a bacteria, especially virus, then these can cause the severe damages for the agricultural crop that can be able to cause the epidemic. Then strong storm and intense flood damage with the help of global warming, that due to the global warming, strong storms and intense flood that can be able to cause very big damage of the plants. Then water crisis and decreased irrigation. Yes, water scarcity or low level of water, due to that water crisis, the irrigation also decreases. Due to the irrigation level can be decreased, the agriculture that can be able to low. Due to the agriculture low means the production of the plant is also low. Then next problem is change in flowering season and pollinator. Yes, the global warming that can be able to affect the seasoning of the flowers. The seasoning that can be able to change means pollinators like honeybee, insect, that also affected. Then the plant, the yield also low. Then change in species distributional ranges. Yes, of course, due to the global warming, the particular season species that can be able to change, that particular season species that can be able to change due to with the help of the global warming. Next one is species extinct. Extinct means that can be able to away from nearer away from our earth system. That is called it as endangered. Exit means a particular species that can be able to removed from our earth atmosphere. Yes, of course, most of the plants that can be able to exit from our earth with the help of global warming. That global warming that can be able to cause a very big drastic change, not only for the human, that can even cause a drastic change in plants, some of the insects, some of the animals, that is call it as a pollinator, that can be cause a very drastic change for the in our universe, especially that is call it as a environment. What are the strategies to deal with global warming? How we can reduce that global warming? What are the steps that can be able to involved in the strategies of the global warming? First one is increasing the vegetation. Yes, first one is planting of more tree, that is call it as increasing the vegetation covers. Then grow more trees. Yes, in roadside, in each home, each house, we have to planting a more number of trees, first thing. Then only increasing the vegetation cover, growing more trees. Next, reducing the usage of fossil fuels and greenhouse gases. Yes, of course, in our home we have a two-wheeler, four-wheeler, then but we have to use the public transport, or we have to use the bicycle, because that bicycle that can be cannot use the fossil fuel, so it can have the capacity to reduce the use of fossil fuel and greenhouse gas. Then developing alternate renewable source of energy. Yes, we have to use the petrol, diesel for the transportation. Instead of that, we have to use the solar bike, solar car. It can be able to reduce their pollution, so the global warming that can be able to reduced. Next one is call it as minimizing usage of nitrogenous fertilizer and aerosols. Yes, we have to use the natural fertilizers instead of chemical or a synthetic fertilizers. Then only we have to capacity to reduce their global warming. In our day-to-day life, we have to reduce the global warming with our efficiency. We have to do that planting of more number of trees in house, roadside, in some of the public park and some other places, especially temple, etc. We want to grow in our school campus also. We have to planting more number of trees in a particular day that can be able to do reduce their global warming and reduce their greenhouse gas level. Next one is, due to that global warming, the one of the major cause, that is ozone depletion. First we know what is ozone. Ozone is nothing but one of the layer that can be able to protect the living organism from the UV rays, that is call it as ozone layer. The ozone is O3. The ozone layer is a region of earth stratosphere that absorbs most of the sun's ultraviolet radiation, that is call it as ozone layer. That ozone layer is otherwise call it as ozone shield, because it can have the capacity to protect the layer for their UV rays. Because the ozone layer is otherwise call it as ozone shield, because it can be able to protect from the UV rays. Here then only it can be able to act as a protective shield, cutting the UV ultraviolet radiation emitted by the sun. UV radiation is nothing but ultraviolet radiation. Then ozone, just above the atmosphere there are two layer, nearly troposphere and stratosphere. The troposphere is the low layer and the stratosphere is the upper layer. That upper layer is called as a ozone shield. That ozone shield that can be able to depleted with the increasing the level of the global warming, that can be able to studied in a detailed